We've all had those tough days when stress has us reaching for junk food, but it turns out there are healthier options. Today, I am with the Balance Babe, Sarah Baker, who's gonna give us some other ideas when it comes to stress relief. Now, Sarah, why is it important to think about our food choices when it comes to stress?
So here's the deal, Jane. When we're stressed and we have an excess of stress, we start to create an excess of cortisol, and that's that hormone that produces that fight or flight response in our bodies. So when we are stressed, we start to crave specific foods that are not healthy for us. So a lot of times, especially for women, that is carbs and sweets.
Is it the cortisol that's making us crave these things? And why did these sweets and these carbs make us feel better? What is it doing?
So when we do reach for carbs or sweets, it spikes our insulin levels. You get crabby, which makes us even more fatigued and brings on even more cravings. So it's just a circle of eating sweets, eating carbs, and then wanting it more.
What are the foods that we should be reaching for when we're stressed?
So the number one thing is folate. So now you can find folate in dark leafy greens, avocado, asparagus. And what that does is when it interacts in your body, it prevents an excess of a specific amino acid that then interferes with you producing your happy hormones like serotonin.
Sometimes we want junk foods because they're salty or they're sweet.
One thing if you're craving salty foods is a fermented miso.
Now, being healthy and eating healthy, as we know, is time consuming. So it's easy to reach for the cupboard of salty snack foods. Talk about the make-ahead factor.
So a lot of these recipes and a lot of healthy recipes are actually easy to make ahead, especially if you make them in bulks. It's all about dedicating that time for yourself.
All right, Sarah, now you've told us all about what to do, so let's put all that into practice. What are we gonna make?
So this is a really easy recipe that you can make. It's protein pistachio oatmeal. So you can have it as a dessert because it's really sweet, or you can just have it as a meal. All you really need to do is get some instant oatmeal, put it in a little jar, and then you just add some almond milk. I like using dairy-free nut milk alternative just because milk brings on more inflammation and the hormones and the antibiotics and all of that.
So, and when you're talking about almond milk, do you want to get the flavored? They have vanilla, they have unsweetened, they have plain. Does it matter?
So I usually get the unsweetened original, just so that there's no added sugars or anything like that. It's a great creamy addition to any recipe. And then you just take a banana. And you can also make this recipe in a bowl. And then you take dates, because dates will also add some sweetness to it. Make sure you pit the dates, because you don't want to be eating any of those things. Chop them up really quickly, mix it all together. We want to have pistachios be the star of the show for this.
Why do we love pistachios?
Oh, they're so great. They're good for your heart health, they're good for your brain health, and they're really great for your mood. And I like adding chia seeds. Chia seeds and hemp seeds are actually two seeds that have omega-3s, amino acids, and proteins. You can blend it all together. So once you're done blending everything together, you can pop it in the fridge for overnight oats. On your way out to work the next day, just grab it and enjoy it as a snack.
I love it, let's try it.
All right.
Okay, cool. Ooh, I'm gonna get some nut.
Yes.
Mmm, really good. Mm-hmm. You can taste the nuttiness, a little bit of the sweetness from the banana. Absolutely delicious.
Packed with so many good benefits too.
Thank you so much for all of these great tips and ideas.